Hi teams, thanks for tuning in for the video tonight. Just a couple of things to update you on, a couple of things different that you'll see straight away. Tonight I've not got my glasses on because if I do, I can't read my notes. And the second one is there's probably quite a nice reflection on the top of my head off that spotlight above me, but if you could just please put up with that, we'll carry on from there. I know tonight it's still a challenging time out there and you're probably still feeling tired, isolated maybe, and even could I go as far as say forgotten, but I really want to make sure that's not how you should be feeling, and we certainly are doing as much as we can to have your back. Hopefully you got a slight lift yesterday from Jason Leach's video, which I thought was great and had some nice messages in it for you, and Matt's as well last night was really well done. Some of the things we've also been doing this morning, that I certainly managed to get a recording on Radio 4th breakfast show with Boogie and Arlene to get a shout out to the network. And I know that's just across part of our network, but you should hear a nice message on Thursday morning regarding that, but they have recorded it. In terms of Matt, he then goes and does one better than that. And he's got a BBC interview scheduled for 10 o'clock tomorrow. So hopefully we'll get the messaging right and get out some information out to the public through that particular medium. Can I move on to some things now in terms of testing you've been asking about? And certainly we are aware that the Chief Medical Officer is giving advice to the Cabinet Secretary today, and we're hoping that we get more clarity on that in the coming days. Some of the key workers in terms of the comments around that, it's not actually specifically a pharmacy and medicines division responsibility, but actually the decision will be fed in by Rosemary, and she's working certainly for you to make sure that we are included in that. In terms of deliveries, specifically around the high risk and vulnerable patients, we're doing something quite different, a different approach in Scotland than England. And I could just also reassure you that despite when Boris Johnson makes statements, all of these things have to go through the Scottish Government with it all being devolved, and we can come to a different solution. And that's what's happened for this patient group. We are taking a very different approach, and we're going to look to do that quite differently and putting that through with the network. But I can assure you, you're not expected to pick up all that burden and add to the already mega workload. In terms of volunteering with deliveries, if someone is volunteering to collect medicines on your behalf, of a patient on their behalf, and the medicine is previously would have required evidence of written consent to hand that over, and the volunteer doesn't have that at that time, I would refer you to the GPHC's advice in these exceptional circumstances, i.e. the regulator accepts that making the patient and volunteer journey more onerous at this time is in no one's best interest, and I would issue the medication. Advice now about volunteers coming into the pharmacy, that's a bit more complicated for us, and it's particularly from an indemnity issue. We're working on guidance for everybody on that, and we hope we'll have that ready for tomorrow. I mentioned Rosemary earlier on there, and our Chief Pharmaceutical Officer letter came out today. That has got many points in it that I'm not going to go through. It should be on our website for you to refer to, and if it isn't, it will soon be up when Graham watches this and realises it needs to go on, but I'm sure it will be there already. One point in the letter that is covered is PPE, so your protective equipment, personal protective equipment. Now, we've heard today that that should start to roll out to you via the wholesalers. Now, I know that might be an interesting choice of a distribution route at the minute, but the Royal Mail's under real capacity issues, and availability of individual couriers is varied. So they've gone with that particular route, and two of the major wholesalers tell us they have capacity to do that just now. Just a word on masks, if I could. There'll be a lot of questions around that. And just reiterate, these are not being supplied at the minute to pharmacies. They're following the science and Health Protection Scotland's advice, and that those are not only being issued to colleagues who will have direct patient-to-patient contact and require examination requirements where aspiration of saliva is highly likely to occur. Now, I know that's not what you want to hear, and it remains current guidance and policy. You may also have heard or picked up changing advice on how long the virus can survive on different surfaces like cardboard and plastic. As yet, We've had no updated advice from Health Protection Scotland on this, and we await any change before informing you of that. Matt mentioned last night the NHS ID cards. That responsibility, again, doesn't sit directly with Rosemary and her department and the colleagues there, but we can assure you that they're feeding in, that all our pharmacy team staff need to be included in this. And again, more detail to follow. And I think that's a frustrating point, because we've got no timescales for most of the things that I'm updating you and we have been telling you, but we will keep pushing to get these things done. Now, can I also thank you, colleagues, for the messages that have come into the office of support for these updated videos that we give you. And we'll do our best to keep these going, because many of you are telling us that you do value them. Rosemary has also spoken to me today and would like to come and record a message for you, and we'll try to get the production team onto that to make that happen. I also hope you get no drop in service level, as we have now actually moved out of Queen Street. We mothballed it last night in advance of any announcement, so we are now out of the office and hopefully can give you the same level of support as we have been doing. We're still manning the phones remotely. We're answering the inquiries inbox, and actually that's the best method to get us, is through the inquiries inbox and putting in the hours behind the scenes to try and support you. So we know from many of your emails and your correspondence that many of you are doing exceptionally long shifts and continuous day working. It's nothing like the same, but we are trying everything we can to be there for you. Robbie, that's producing these videos at night, has been working every day, and another member of the team has been doing so as well. And it's similar to what many of you are experiencing. Now, Matt signed off last night with a slightly lighter note and a message from Jonathan Ross, as he did a review on the Pikachu movie. So I'm going to try and do something a wee bit different for you tonight, and a bit of light relief. So it's Name That Tune tonight. So here's an introduction from a really well-known song that is hardly played in full. So we need the title and the artist, please. There you go. That's enough of that. Matt will give you the answer to tomorrow night. And thanks again, everybody, for tuning in. And we'll be back in touch tomorrow. Thanks very much.